Skid Row Joe. Last night, that's who I found in the dirty part of town. Lost, forgotten, with no place to go. Tormented with a bitter taste, outcast by the human race. A mask of torture was the face of Skid Row Joe. He walked up to where I stood on the street and said, "Pardon me, mister. Now don't get me wrong, I don't want your money, though heaven knows I could use it. But you see, this is my home. You see the other bar down the street there? That's my home too." He said, "I noticed you staring at me a while ago. You recognized me, didn't you?" I said, "Yeah, Joe, I know who you are. You was one time a real famous singing star, one of my favorites." He said, "Well, I guess you heard they took my babies away from me." I said, "Yeah, Joe, I read about it in the papers." Then he turned his head away, and I saw the tears fall into place. And he turned to me and he said, "You know, mister, this is the only place in the world that I'm not ashamed to show my face. But I'm gonna quit. Yes, sir, I'm gonna quit. And I'm gonna shave and comb my hair, get me a clean white shirt. Then I'm gonna walk up to her door. And when she answers, I'm gonna stand up real proud, tall. Then I'm gonna get down on my knees. And I'll say, 'Sweetheart, if you'll take me back, I'll spend the rest of my life making it up to you for what I've done. I'm so ashamed of myself. This I want you to know.' Then I'm gonna take my two little babies and hold them so close to me, I ain't gonna ever let them go." I guess I should have told him then that she'd already remarried again. But after hearing what he'd said to me, well, there wasn't no way that I could add to his misery. So I said, "Good luck, and my best to you, Skid Row Joe."